Good morning and good evening to everyone. Let's take a few moments to let both body and mind settle, to settle quietly, to settle evenly, to settle naturally.
Hello, 晚上好，我们现在一起来稍微让我们的身心沉淀下来。
To let body and mind settle, another way to put it is to let body, speech, and mind to become quiet. And so to do that, we need to have both patience and attention. Patience, because you cannot force don't try to force your body, speech, and mind to settle, but rather to leave them alone. Now, this is not leave them alone without being present. As we say, this is not like turning on the TV and letting the TV babysit your child. So this child we're talking about now is this mind, principally. But body and mind, you let them settle, but you cannot go do something else somewhere. So you also needed to have attention present.
So we do wrong the Shen Xin Gates and the Chen Tian Xia, Zhu Yao Shi Shu, woman the San Men, it just show them the Shen Yu Yi, around her being the Ji Jing. Rao Nango Tama Chu, Mashia Lang and Zong Putan and the Touch, because Nai Xin, because Zhuan Zhu. No, Nai Xin Xin Wei, woman, Buya Rang, Bushi Togo Man Li, Rao Rang, woman the Shen Yu Yi Chen Tian Xia.而是就让它自然的沉淀下来，不去干扰它，而不是，但是却不是像那种我们让我们的电视就去安抚我们的小孩那样的，就让它自然，而是我们也需要处在那个环境，然后去提供相应的一种关注。所以第二个特质就是去关注。
Since as long as we're alive, breath is a constant and present object. The Buddha particularly has taught his disciples to turn to breath as an object to allow attention to coalesce, attention to gather around the object of breath. So you might want to experiment with that, with breath as the object.
从我们就是出生到现在，其实我们的呼吸就是一个恒常存在的所缘对象。那佛陀也教导他的弟子，就让把专注力安顿在这个呼吸，所以我们可以尝试就让去体验呼吸的存在。
For you to direct your attention towards. Personally, I prefer a less tight focus, but a more open and pervasive focus, which is the entire body experiencing breath. So as you inhale, your felt sense, your body expanding outwards. As you exhale, the body contracting inwards. And so then outwards, inwards, outwards, inwards. So I personally like to use that. But of course, you should experiment and find the focal point that works for you. The other very popular, or in fact more popular than this one, is to have a tighter focal point, which is in this space around the nostril, on the front, on the top of your upper lip, between the nose and the upper lip, where breath enters and exits. Then another very popular focal point is the abdomen, rising and falling. So you can experiment with any of these. You can, in fact, I feel that you can switch as appropriate. Each of these focal points have certain advantages and certain disadvantages. I believe that rather than getting fanatical about, you know, only this focal point or that focal point, it's better to approach this with a broader understanding of why we are anchoring our thoughts, our attention on breath and all the various aspects of breath, and both their strengths and their weaknesses.
就是把我们的专注力安住在我们的呼吸上，那这个方式基本上有两种不同的方法，一个是李博士建议的是比较相对比较自在、比较轻松的，也就是说我们的关注不会那么的紧绷，而是用一个更加宽广的一种关注来。全身心的体验这个呼吸，也就是说，当我们吸进的时候，我们感觉到就是，我们的身体是往外的；然后当我们呼出的时候，我们可以感觉到我们是往内的。那这个我们每个人都需要透过自己亲身的体验去尝试，然后去找到适合我们自己的一个关注点。那另外一种方式则是相对比较紧绷，就相对的比较紧的一种专注的点，也就是说在我们的鼻端，也就是上唇的位置，我们把专注力放在我们上唇，然后在鼻端的位置，然后去关注呼吸的进出。或者是另外一个方式则是去觉察我们的腹部浮起，就是当我们吸进的时候它浮起，然后呼出的时候它就是陷入的一种移动。然后其实这整个体验呼吸的过程都是一种实验，我们必须依据我们自己的相应的方式来尝试，然后找到最恰当的一种方式。而有时候其实也是建议大家可以就是去交替的来使用，就了解到其实这两种不同的方式它都会有它自己的优缺点。那与其就是很紧绷的依据传统的一种方式，那更重要的其实是我们要了解为什么我们要把专注力安顿在呼吸上，这个是更重要的。
Then you can also experiment with whether you want to keep your eyes open or closed. If you keep your eyes open, it's not like wide open, but simply open so that your gaze is along the bridge of your nose. Your gaze is along the bridge of your nose towards the tip of your nose, and then from the tip of your nose down to the space in front, wherever your sight lands, let your sight just rest in that general area without forcing, without focusing. So that is how you would keep your eyes open. Even though habitually we think, you know, during formal meditation, you close your eyes, closing your eyes might not work for everyone. In fact, there are a few traditions that emphasizes not closing eyes. But again, just be aware of these two approaches and as appropriate, adopt the one that is working for you best.
Just 除此之外，大家也可以尝试去测试， 自己是想要让我们的眼睛就张开或者是关闭，然后如果张开就在我们觉察整个呼吸的进出的时候，如果让我们的眼睛张开的话，不是张得大大的，而是说就微开，然后让我们的视线随着我们的鼻梁，然后停顿在我们眼前的一个空间上，然后让我们的视线就是很自然的停住。然后因为虽然传统来说我们一般上会就把眼睛闭上，但是不是每个人都这样的方式对每个人有效，所以可能我们需要觉察到有这两种不同的方式，而我们自己去尝试，然后再选取适合我们的。
kadang nyampe senjen tomje deva dang dewe gendan dan pragyuji dungyao dang dungyao gi gudan deva gyuji dungyao mebe deva dame deva gyuji nirin chadang nidang deva dang nyong la ne pragyuji amanang kadang nyampe senjen tomje deva dang dewe gendan dan pragyuji dungyao dang dungyao gi gudan deva gyuji dungyao mebe deva dame deva gyuji nirin chadang nidang deva dang nyong la ne pragyuji。And then the seven branch puja in the different languages.
便是普贤菩萨行愿品七支供养。
In all the world,
所有十方世界中，三世一切人师子，我以清净身语一切遍尽。
Humans, I prostrate joyfully with body, speech, and mind by the power of this aspiration to noble deeds, all conquerors appear vividly in my mind with as many bodies as there are atoms in all lands. I prostrate to all you conquerors. In each atom of Buddhas, numerless as atoms, all in the midst of the heirs of the Buddhas.Thus I conceive of this Dharma Dhatu as completely filled with you conquerors in this way, with infinite oceans of praise and oceans of diverse melodies, I sing the excellent qualities of all you conquerors.
以诸最圣妙华满，伎乐图香起闪盖，如是最圣庄严具，我以供养诸如来。最圣衣服、最圣香、末香、烧香与灯烛，一皆如妙高具，我悉供养诸如来。我以广大圣戒心，深信一切三世佛，悉以普贤行愿力，普遍供养诸如来。
These vast and unequal offerings to each and every one of you conquerors, with the power of conviction and noble deeds, I prostrate and offer to all you conquerors. All the harmful deeds that I have done with my body, speech, and mind, under the power of desire, hatred, and ignorance.I confess each and every one of them. I rejoice in all the meritorious deeds of all conquerors in the ten directions and the heirs of the Buddhas, all materializers, hearers still in training and beyond, and all wandering beings.
十方所有世间灯最初成就菩提者，我今一切皆劝请转于无上妙法轮。
All you who are my protectors, please turn the unexcelled wheel of dharma with palms together. I earnestly beseech you who intend to manifest final nirvana. Please remain for as many eons as there are atoms in the world for the happiness and well-being of all wandering beings.
所有礼瞻供养福，请佛住持转法轮，随喜忏悔，诸善根，回向众生及佛道。
I now dedicate to complete Bodhi. Sanjay Shintu Meite Puvayi 这个南无大行了，给我的说，故作用作拉美措南了，吉囊藏孙得心尼给说，大罗龙觉能西永谢了，拉美求给我的就读说，加瑟瓦达求经上巴达，吉瑟依让苦行受瓦依。给我众生大吉吉萨巴，他们皆娑婆，常住吉隆坡。唵咕噜德瓦达吉尼拉那曼达拉布提迦娑诃。舍利南吉桑巴达，罗耶吉扎吉达瓦，吉琼图蒙提巴耶，卓吉果罗果多娑。多吉长曼德勒那罗达玛弥达波巴多吉登果。各等尊等者为了美上三句喇嘛一当作用了说法的时候，大吉坚决罗伽本给都没能能跟着被动使用了个，从没给我多接长跑几等功倍上了多多，他都从给来没坚决了些土姐姐能跟我摆上了那江山土地路都不坚决了，坚决坚的掌上白马给啥东坡了杨三就跟我对面。本末就能学学这过度感度嘛，不过给给就是多的给点钱了，就是说过度本末是的。我们就给一给不断的都是三句关键我问你，人生就跟我说动词把稍微了没少了说话的。Want to take this opportunity to give some suggestions and also share in inspiring all of us. So one of our participants is planning to do a 3 months retreat at the retreat center. And so this is of course something that is very good to do if we have those circumstances, and if we don't have those circumstances you have to create those circumstances. So Buddha's teaching is about karma, it's about action, skillful action. It is not wait around for something to happen or unskillfully forcing things to happen. And so we have to create those conditions. We have to skillfully remove things that are standing in our way from doing such focus practice. So whether it's 3 months, whether it's 10 days, whether it's 2 days, whether it's 1 day, it's our effort to actually do it. It's not to say, 3 months definitely you will kind of progress more as compared to 1 day. It's not sure. Important thing is we are inspired to create those conditions for such focused practice to take place.
And 李博士想趁这个机会，然后就跟各位分享一个就成。激励人心的一个讯息，就是说我们其中一位参与者然后决定想要去进行3个月的闭关，就到闭关中心进行3个月的闭关。然后其实如果大家有这样的一个因缘可以去就是做比较密集的闭关是非常好的事情。 那佛陀的教法关于业果来说，其实是善巧的行为。我们不是坐在这里然后就等着事情发生，或者是不善巧的去逼迫或者是防止一些事情发生，而是我们怎么去制造或者是去成就这个善巧的行为。无论是三个月还是十天还是两天，其实重要的是我们的动力，我们想要去成就这一件事情，想要去成就密集闭关或者是自我修持的这样的一种行为。然后当然也不是说你去了三个月的闭关就表示你可能比一天的闭关的成就来得更大，并不是那么一回事。最重要的，我们听到这样的一个讯息，我们可以就深受鼓励，去制造更多修行的因缘，让我们能够投入其中。
Likewise, you know, again, someone in this group, I know, just completed 10 days of retreat as well. So that's all, you know, very good if we're able to do this. Particularly, I was asked, you know,how about if these 3 months of retreat is mostly focused on Bodhicayavatara? How would one schedule have a retreat, focus on this particular subject that we have been studying together? So I think in terms of like,what do you actually do if you wanted to have Bodhicayavatara as the focus? Then I think it might actually be very good to have, say, for example, the Lion's Fountain Bodhicitta practice that I shared with you recently, that His Holiness the Drigon Kyabgun composed. If you want, you can do like 4 sessions of that each day.
Ah, 当然，同时其实在这一组也有另外一位同学，他已经完成了10天的这个密集的闭关，所以这也是非常好，非常随喜的。那特别就是李博士被询问说，那如果这个三个月的密集闭关是想要针对我们目前正在学习的这个主题，也就是入菩萨行论的话，我们应该怎么样去安排我们的时间，应该怎么进行呢？然后李博士就建议说，如果当我们实际要去做的话，然后着重在这个入菩萨行论，那我们可以采用上个星期，就星期六，上个星期六李博士刚刚跟大家分享的，就由子贡法王所撰述的摘录的这一个狮子泉的这个菩提心修持，那个修持，那个简短的一个修持资料。然后如果大家想要的话，可以一天就是可以进行四座这个菩提心的修持，根据那一个短文。
So at the beginning, I would say, when you use that practice text, when you use that sadhana for the 4 sessions, you keep each of the sessions of practice short. Maybe just half an hour or even less than half an hour, 20 minutes. Then after you finish the formal practice session, while still seated, you begin reading the Bodhicayavatara. So, in fact, then your session consists of begins with the bodhicitta practice for 20 minutes, for half an hour, then continuing on from there to reading Bodhicayavatara, but reading, you know, verse by verse slowly. Reading verse by verse slowly, slowly, slowly. And you might do that for the next hour. You experiment yourself, you know. You might read slowly, one verse, pause, one verse, pause. Or, you know, read like 10 verses, or read till a logical point where you stop and you pause. So then you maybe do that for 1 hour or 1.5 hours. It's up to you, right? Then you take a break. Then next session, again, you start with the formal practice of about 20 minutes, half an hour. So you do that. Now, especially if your retreat time is 3 months, then slowly, slowly, what you're working towards is this practice, formal practice session, can become longer and longer and longer. Then the reading of the text becomes shorter and shorter and shorter. Then you are doing more watching the mind based on what you are absorbing from Bodhicayavatara. Then you do watching the mind. So doing that formal practice, it's not just like mouth reciting, it's watching the mind.
就这一个，一开始的时候，就是当我们进，就是在这个三个月的密集闭关里面，一开始的时候，你可以用这一个，菩提心的这个修持。然后就是一天可以进行四座的修持，然后让每一座它的时间不要太长，可能半个小时或者是少过半个小时，可能20分钟，然后就是去念诵这一个经文里面的内容，然后进行这个正式的修持。然后当结束了之后，当我们还在坐着的时候，我们就开始阅读《入菩萨行论》，然后实际上在这一个修持的这一座里面，我们首先是以菩提心的修持开始，然后接下来就是阅读《入菩萨行论》，然后阅读《入菩萨行论》一记一记缓缓的，然后可能就是用一个小时或者是一个小时半的时间，那自己可以去尝试它的变化。可能你是念了一记之后，然后休息停顿一下，然后再念下一记，又或者是你可以一次念十记之后停顿，又或者是你一直读一直读，读到某一个点是你觉得值得去思维的，就是想要更进一步思维的，然后就停顿。所以这个部分可以做一个小时或者是一个半小时，然后结束了之后，这整座结束了之后，我们就休息一会儿，然后休息一段时间，然后下一段时间又重新开始菩提心的修持，然后20到30分钟，然后接下来又继续持诵入菩萨行论。那既然这个是三个月的密集闭关，那就在整个过程里面，正式的修持在往后的时间就慢慢的拉长，然后在阅读的时间就慢慢的缩短，然后最主要的慢慢的从单纯的念诵，然后转到去观察我们的心。就当我们在入菩萨行论里面已经吸收的内容，然后我们用那样的一个内容来观我们的心。所以在整个正式的修持里面，不只是嘴巴念，而是我们持续的去关照我们的心思。
Then also at the beginning, maybe your 4 sessions, keep it shorter. So at the beginning of the retreat, your formal session might, maybe you just say, I will have 4 1-hour sessions. Right? So then what it means that is that in between sessions, you have, you know, a couple of hours, right? Because in a day, your waking hour is not just 4 hours. Yeah? So then you have like maybe even 2 hours in between sessions, right? During those 2 hours, you don't need to sit on your cushion. You get up on the chair. If you have commentaries of the Bodhicayavatara, you can do a more like study, you know. Or if you have recordings of the Bodhicayavatara teachings. So before the retreat, you gather all these things. So during break session, in a more relaxed way, you listen to the teachings, you take notes. So again, the idea is that at the very beginning, you want to not make it such a big contrast, you know, from your busy life to like completely just, you know, very strict into retreat. Because then, you know, it will create problems, actually. So at the beginning of your retreat, the formal session, keep it short, keep it sweet, as they say, so that you enjoy. But in between session, don't get distracted and say, oh, I'm just going to read a novel. I'm going to read the news. No, don't do that. You know, you limit your non-formal session, you limit your post-meditation to still engaging in the main topic, Bodhicayavatara. Or you can also introduce, like during the break time, you can sit by the window and then you play a particular mantra and you are chanting along in your mind. It's okay, you know, even if you are sipping your tea or coffee, you know, just letting the mind relax with the mantra. So slowly, you know, let it kind of enter your system. Idea here is that over time, your in-between sessions become shorter and shorter. Your reading, your taking notes becomes shorter and shorter. And your just settling and watching your mind becoming longer and longer.
那在一开始的时候就尝试不要去让自己的平时的生活和这一个就是闭关的生活产生非常大的一个距离，就尽可能让那个四座的修持时间减短，可能就是一天里面就是这四座的修持，然后这四座就用每一座都是一个小时的时间，然后一个小时的时间，那在这四座之间就会有非常长的一个空隙。那在这个空隙里头，可能我们并没有就是在禅坐，但是我们可以做一些相对比较轻松的一些阅读，可能就把相关的就关于入菩萨行论的一些注释，或者是这一些录影之类的，然后准备好，然后那个时候就可以拿来听，然后就做笔记，就可以很轻松的学习的一种状态，然后就尽可能让它比较简短，让我们可以享受。但是在这个正式的每一座的时间之间，这个相对非正式的这个时段的话，尽可能不要让自己的心就去做跟修持没有任何关系的活动，就可能去看新闻啊，或者是去看些别的东西，都不要，还是一样把心维持在这个主题上，但是可以相对的比较轻松，就是可以坐在窗口旁边，然后可能就是播个那个咒语的一个录音，然后在心里面就跟着持诵，然后让心比较自在，让这一个咒语可以进入我们的心。然后这个关键最主要的是说，当我们慢慢修持，在这整个三个月的闭关的过程中，然后这个间隙就是正式修持的时间，它会变得越来越长。 然后那个间隙的时间就变得越来越短。也就是说，我们就是阅读的时间相对的变得越来越短，然后那个安顿自己身心的这个状况，观察自己身心的这个时间变得越来越长。
When our mind is tired, you know, it's hard to work with it. When our mind feels like forced, you know, it's hard to work with it.
当我们感到我们的心感到疲惫的时候，其实是很难进行。然后，如果当我们感觉到很有压力的时候，其实也是非常难进行。
But when our mind is relaxed and inspired, you know, then it's so easy to work with it.
当我们的心如果是相对比较轻松，然后就深受启发的话，就会很容易的进入状况。
So don't do things, you know, to kill your inspiration when you are attempting to do a short retreat. Yeah.
所以不要做任何就是去扼杀你深受启发这样的一种动力，在我特别是在我们就闭关的时候。
The Tibetan word for retreat is tsam. Tsam means boundary.
然后藏语就是关于这个闭关其实是 tsam， 也就是边界、结界的意思。
It means setting a boundary and remaining within this boundary.
也就是说，我们去设定这个结界，然后维持在这个结界中。
So not like crossing the boundary.
也就是不跨越这个结界。
So the English word that we use, maybe, I don't know, maybe not relevant to Chinese or Spanish, but the English word we use, retreat, doesn't really communicate, you know, what is going on. Retreat sounds like, you know, the army is losing, you know, now it's time to retreat. Back away, back away, back away, you know, run away, retreat, you know. This is not running away, yeah. It's setting a boundary. Who sets the boundary? You set the boundary. And once you set the boundary, then you respect that boundary.
在英文就是 retreat, 其实它并没有带出这一个闭关的概念。因为在英文 retreat 的话，就是当这个军队就输掉了，然后他就往后退，这一种叫 retreat。但是在这一边闭关，实际上是我们设定一个结界，然后我们尊重这个结界。
And yes, of course, you know, these days, retreat, especially in the West, you know, we think of spa, we think of jacuzzi.We think of, you know, all those things, and we think, ah.
啊，当然，现在在西方社会，就是这个 retreat， 然后会让人就想到可能就是spa 或者是这一种享受的。
But if you have discipline, you can work that into your retreat, especially at the beginning, because you need something to encourage you.
所以如果你自己自律的话，其实这样的一种元素在特别是在一开始的时候也是可以采取可行的。
Sometimes, you know, Buddhist practice, we think, you know, it's all about suffering.
有时候我们可能就佛教的一种修辞常常就会联想到苦。
So young people don't want to go with their parents to Buddhist things. They think it's just miserable.
就年轻人可能就不愿意跟着他们的父母去就佛教的道场，因为就觉得就是苦啊。
So those of you who are in Buddhist cultures, you know, where for generations have been Buddhist, you have to think a little bit more about what is necessary.these days to keep young people interested in finding Buddhism relevant and Buddhist practice relevant and helpful to their lives. As much as we might be inspired by Milarepa, you know, and don't go forcing everyone to be Milarepa. Then everyone will run away, you know.
啊，特别就是像我们这一些在佛教的文化里面，好一段时间的人，修行人，可能要思考一下，就是到底对现在的年轻人来说，什么才是具有吸引力的、需要的，可以让对他们生活有帮助的？因为我们可能自己对是被密勒日巴尊者所吸引，或者是的深受启发，但是我们不能够
lacking skillful means, lacking skill, and then just forcing our agenda. It's one work, you know, whether it's with young people or a young mind. When we're just starting to want to do some retreat, something wanting to do some tham, you know.We have this grandiose idea of like, you know, oh, it will be 18 hours, you know, I will not move, you know. Even if you last the first day for 18 hours, the next day, you start fantasizing about how do I explain to people that I have stopped my retreat and I have come home now because, oh my gosh, the first day of 18 hours is just terrible. So...You know, probably like your 1 week retreat, you know, the other 6 days is spent thinking about ways to escape. Then on the seventh day, it's like, yay, finally, I don't need to escape. I can now leave and, you know, say to people, oh, I finished 1 week retreat.
就刚刚提到说，就虽然我们自己可能就是被密勒日巴尊者所启发，但是不要把我们这样的一种动机就是放在他人身上，这个是相对不善巧的一种行为。我们需要了解到，就是年轻人或者是一个年轻的心，他们需要的是什么。然后可能一开始如果被一种传统的一种概念困着，就一天里面就18个小时就不移动，然后可能第二天就已经开始放弃了。然后那7天的闭关，第一天非常的精进，然后后面的6天其实都不断的在思考着怎么样逃离，然后终于到了最后一天，终于可以松一口气，可以躲开了。
And the point of doing tham is not so that, you know, I feel, if I don't know, maybe different people tell you different things. The point of tham is not so that you separate your life into tham and not tham.You do a week of tham and then 3 weeks of craziness and then 2 weeks of tham and 2 weeks of craziness. Then you increase, 3 weeks of tham and 1 week of craziness. So back and forth like that. No, the point of doing tham is so that your formal period of tham of retreat andYour day-to-day life becomes more and more similar. So that then your day-to-day life becomes more and more like the times that you have, you are doing tham.
而真正就是为什么我们要去闭关，其实不是要把我们平时的生活和闭关的生活区隔开来，可能我们就是进行一个星期的闭关，然后就另外3个星期然后就投入就日常的疯狂，或者是来来回回这样的一回事。其实不是，真正的闭关其实是让我们在闭关的生活和我们日常的生活变得越来越相近，然后让我们哪怕在日常的生活，我们的心也能够像在闭关时那样的安定。
You cannot like party hard, retreat hard, party hard, retreat hard.
你不能够就是非常努力的就是去玩乐，然后非常努力的在进行闭关，那不可能的。
The effects of tham is supposed to change your quote unquote regular life.
其实闭关最主要的，它的功能，它的影响是要能够转化我们的日常生活。
Then your regular life, you know, can slowly, slowly become, you know, lifelong Tham.
那么我们的日常生活就能够变成一个恒常的闭关生活了。
Finally, one point about the, just to point out, the Lion's Fountain, Bodhicitta practice, right? So one of the sections in there is the four causes of Bodhicitta. One is the one called Special Refuge. So when you do the Special Refuge part, you can do prostrations during that section. To match with your taking special refuge, extraordinary refuge.
最后就是最后的一个提醒，就是当我们在修持那个狮子泉源的这一个菩提心的这个经文的时候，然后里面有一个部分是谈到于升起菩提心的四个因，其中一个就是这个殊胜的皈依。那在受持这个殊胜的皈依的时候，其实我们可以进行大礼拜，就当我们在持诵的时候可以一边进行那样的一个大礼拜。
So if you have registered for this course directly with us, Drigong Dhammakirti, then you should be on that mailing list. Then you should have received the two texts that we shared recently.If you have not registered with us officially and you want to be in that mailing list, maybe now in the Zoom chat, you can give your email address, then we will put you in that mailing list.
就是如果大家是有
Of course, right now our communication is just in English, mostly, and sometimes Spanish.
然后如果大家是有跟我们的这个团体登记这一个入菩萨行愿的课程的话，那可能你就会收到就是我们的这个联系。然后在最近最新的这个mail 里面，就是这个经文其实就有附上。但是如果你没有收到我们的任何的联系的话，你想要就是加入我们这个联系，也可以在这个 chat box 里面，就是提供你的 email， 然后我们会把你加入我们的这个联系的行列。
So last class we around verse 18 of chapter 5. So now let's read from 18 to 22 this section.Therefore, I will take in hand and well protect this mind of mine. What use to me are many disciplines if I can't guard and discipline my mind? When in wild, unruly crowds, I am careful and attentive of my wounds. Likewise, when in evil company, this wound my mind shall constantly protect.For if I carefully protect my wounds because I fear the pain of minor injuries, why should I not protect the wound that is my mind for fear of being crushed beneath the cliffs of hell? If this is how I act and live, then even in the midst of evil folk, or even with fair women, all is well. My steady keeping of the vows will not decline. My property, my honor, all can freely go, my body and my livelihood as well. And even other virtues may decline, but never will I let my mind regress. So here, Shantideva is comparing the need to protect our mind through vigilant introspection. And remember this topic of chapter 5, vigilant introspection is dependent on first having knowledge and remembrance of what we should cultivate, what we should let go, what we should adopt, what we should discard. In other words, all the prescription and proscriptions the Buddha gave. Buddha taught clearly, these things lead to suffering. Don't do them. Avoid them. Minimize them. These things, these actions are productive of temporary happiness and ultimate happiness. Cultivate them. Encourage them. So first, that knowledge has to be present. Then when that knowledge is present, and that is actually the word mindfulness, what we translate as mindfulness is used in the traditional text, smriti, meaning remembering, not forgetting. Then vigilant introspection is applying that knowledge to our day-to-day situations that arise as we go about our lives. So the analogy might be, you say, remembering those precepts is like the weapon. Vigilant introspection is like the guard. So the guard holding the weapon allows the property from harm. So Shantideva says, we really need to protect our mind in this way, as if we are someone who have a physical injury and wound. When you have a physical injury and wound, say you have broken your hand, right, and you're on a sling, then if you find yourself, you know, in like a crowd of people having a good time, you know, swinging around their hands, moving around a lot, oh, you are careful, you know. He says likewise, when our mind is weak and we find ourselves in a place where we are being challenged, then we need vigilant introspection. We need the quality that is described in chapter 5 to protect our mind.
正念正知，我们是需要依赖于我们所拥有的知识，然后而且不忘记我们所具有的知识。也就是说，我们要知道什么东西我们需要去除的，然后什么东西我们是要培养的，然后就是任何导致苦的因，我们必须要对治，必须要去除。任何可以带来短暂的快乐乃至长远的快乐，我们必须要去培养，去鼓励。那这个的前提就是相对的知识必须要存在。那这个其实是跟我们前章的特质有关，也就是正念，就在梵语来说是 smriti， 也就是说意识不会忘记。那接下来这一章的正念正知就是说，把我们知道知识可以运用在日常生活中，然后有这样的一个譬喻，就是说正念正念它本身的一个概念，就是说像那个武器一样。那正知呢，就是这一个守护抓着这一个武器，然后守护免于受到伤害这样的一个特质。所以我们需要去保护我们的心，让我们可以免于受到伤害。所以在这边也提到一个譬喻，就是说那个农场，如果我们自己身上有伤害、有伤的话，当我们就是走过一群比较疯狂的人，我们会非常非常的小心去照顾我们的伤。那同样的，当我们的心非常弱的时候，其实我们也需要这一个正念正知的这样的一个力量来保护我们的心，免于陷入苦恼中。
So remember that this chapter is also about disciplined conduct, one of the paramitas. So here, again, Shantideva doesn't go into listing out all the rules of training, the precepts, the vows. But that's understood. So the knowing what the precepts are, knowing what the vows are, knowing the do's and the don'ts that the Buddha have clearly taught. So again, the analogy I use, that's like having the weapons. Now, this guard of introspection, this guard needs to do the guard's work. If you have only introspection, but you don't have the weapons, so to say, meaning if you don't know what the precepts are, then not very useful either. Because then you cannot really protect this treasure, this mind. So you need both.
就是同时提醒大家，就是说这一章其实也是关于戒行，就是其中持戒，其中一个波罗蜜。那齐天菩萨在这边并没有把就是这一些戒行列出来，因为他的对象，基于他的对象的话，这一边这样的一种学处其实是大家都了解，就是佛陀所教导的这一些我们应该做和不应该做的内容，大家都非常清楚。那就像刚刚所提到的这个例子，就是。正念就是像那个武器一样，而正知就是那个守卫，那知道守卫应该要怎么去进行他的工作，去进行保护。那如果前提我们不知道我们的戒到底是什么样的一个内容的话，我们就没有办法去保护，所以我们必须同时具备正念和正知。
So verse 21, he says, you know, and if this is how I act and live, so if I know how to live according to this way, which is to always know that I need to protect my mind, and I can protect my mind with these things that the Buddha has taught and the Buddha has made very clear, then he says, then after that, you know, so he's showing us a way to live whereby if we have this vigilant introspection, which necessarily mindfulness or remembering what to do and what to not to do is all there. When we have this, he says, then we don't need to fear being around the world. We don't need to fear anymore. Then he says, you know, even among, in the midst of evil folk, translated here in the translation I have, he says, even in the midst of bad people. And what it means there is people who provoke us into becoming angry. He says, even if we are among those people now, no problem, because we will not so easily be provoked. We will not get tricked so easily. Then he says, or even among fair women. So here, of course, again, don't misunderstand. It's not saying that women, beautiful women are bad. It's talking about how it would provoke in a monk, probably among these young monks that he's talking to, you know, it will provoke them to have like desire and lust. But he says, when you have this kind of introspection, both even in the midst of situations that will normally provoke attachment or aversion, you are well protected. You will be steady in keeping your vows and not decline.
第二十一计基本上是吉天菩萨说，如果我知道我应该就怎么去生活，也就是说我知道我要就依循佛陀的教诲怎么来保护我的心，然后就怎么样去透过正念正知这两个特质来保护自己的话，其实我不需要害怕，哪怕是在一群的恶人之中就可以轻易的让我的愤怒被挑起，或者是哪怕是在一群漂亮的女人当中，就可能这个是针对那些年轻的生人，然后可能那个欲望就会轻易的被挑起。但是哪怕是在这种种的会引起贪 跟嗔的状况中，其实只要有正念正知，我们的戒都能够很好的被守护。
So, my example I will use here, okay? Maybe you don't accept this, I don't know. It's like, you can go out, you know? It's not so dangerous. You can go out. Yeah? You have as much protection as we currently are able to do. When you have, you do these things and you are careful, then you can go out and then you don't need to be so exposed. But if you don't have vaccine and you don't want the mask, then not 100%, but you are exposing yourself. As an analogy, okay? We don't need to get into whether you agree or you don't agree, real or not real, all of that.
李博士给了一个例子，就是说在现在疫情的这个过程，然后其实你可以就是出门，然后只要就你的能力范围内你能够做到的最大的一个保护，可能就包括就是就打了疫苗，然后戴上口罩之类的，然后就是出去可以出去，但是如果你没有疫苗，然后你不愿意打就是戴口罩的或者是勤洗手的话，那可能就会让自己暴露于危险当中。
When I was a child, I was born and grew up in Malaysia. You know, tuberculosis was a very real threat. You know? So I, you know, vaccinated. I didn't die of TB as a child, and I'm still alive here today. So in that way, you know, I'm sure there were people then maybe got their TB and may also succumb to TB. But it's about, you know, likewise here, you know, no guarantee, yes? No guarantee that when you have that kind of mindfulness, you have introspection, no afflictive emotions will absolutely arise again. No guarantee that you will never be harmed again. But with mindfulness and vigilant introspection, then even when you are in the midst of danger, whether the danger of attachment arising or aversion arising, you will have a very good chance of not being completely destroyed. It says here, and crushed beneath the cliffs of hell.
And 就是李博士说，那他就从小在马来西亚长大，那在他小的时候就是那个肺炎是非常严重的，所以他就打了疫苗，然后他相信当时候也有人就是得到这样的一个肺炎，然后后来他们也是一样就得以生存。所以其实并没有，并不是说当我们拥有正念正知，我们就完完全全的免于受到任何的伤害，但是当我们有正念正知的时候，哪怕我们是在危险当中，也就是说当我们是在
maybe you will feel, you know, a little bit of the heat of hell, you know, burn some hair, you know, on your body, but you will not be crushed beneath the cliffs of hell.
就是可能我们就是处于危险当中，就可能就是贪和嗔就有就燃起的机会，但是当我们有正念正知的时候，我们就可以有很大的机会免于被受到伤害，或者是被抛到地狱中。
22, you know, he says, my property, my honor, my body, my livelihood, and even any other of these virtues, you know, they may decline, they may go, but my mind should not become worse. Meaning the skillful states of mind that have been cultivated should not decline. Particularly, the supremely skillful mind is the body mind, bodhicitta, should not decline. Here, Shantideva is not saying all the other virtues, livelihood, body, honor, property is not important. They are not important compared to the bodhicitta mind. But otherwise, they are important. But if between giving up bodhicitta mind and giving up these other things, then he says these other things can go. So it's also helping us understand, you know, if we understand how precious bodhicitta mind is, whatever setbacks that we face, you know, losing this, losing that, you know, losing things that we like, losing conditions that we like, losing people that we like. Yeah? It's sad, of course, but we won't get carried away. We will remember, oh, but I have bodhicitta infused together with my mind. And that's most precious, that's most important. So in verse 22, he's saying that.
在第22节提到说，我们所拥有的一切，我们的财产，我们的吃具，我们的功德，这一切，我们的活计等等的，就是哪怕它会消散，它会离开，但是我的这一个心，也就是我这个善巧的心的状态，它是不会退失的。这个善巧的心的状态，就是我们的菩提心，它是不会退失的。 所以今天菩萨在这边不是说其他的不重要，就刚刚就是所罗列出来的那些东西不重要，而是比起菩提心的话，其他的东西都可以舍弃。那其实从中也让我们了解到说，菩提心本身是多么多么的珍贵，哪怕我们可能遭遇到非常多的厄难或者是很多的不如意，然后当然我们会感到非常的沮丧难过，但是 只要我们的菩提心还在，我们就不会轻易的被打倒。So
verse 23, Shantideva summarizes that section. So he says, please. So he says, I put my hands together. So now here he is basically, he's pleading with us. He says, please, please protect your own mind. Please protect yourself. Because if you don't protect yourself, you will become the cause of other people's suffering. So please protect yourself. Please protect your mind. And so then here, what is the protection? In what form? In having mindfulness. Mindfulness of what is to be adopted, what is to be discarded. Introspection, applying that knowledge into day-to-day situations that arise. He says, guard these two things. Make sure you have these two things, even at the cost of life and limb. Even if it means losing this life, if you guard these, your mind strongly, protect your mind, protect yourself, then in future lifetimes, your training can continue. So he says, please protect yourself, because by protecting yourself from the bodhisattva perspective, when we protect ourselves, and why are we protecting ourselves? Not because we care that much about ourselves, but we protect ourselves so that, first of all, we don't harm other people, and moreover, we can protect other people. That's the essence of bodhisattva practice.
And in the 23rd 记, basically, 吉天菩萨就是总结这一段，就是说，祈求大家能够好好的守护自己的心，因为如果我们不去守护自己的心的话，会导致非常其他人受苦。那这个守护其中包括这两个特质，一个就是拥有正念，也就是说清楚知道什么应该做，什么不应该做，什么是我们要培养的，什么是我们要去除的。然后就正知，则是把这样的一个知识，这样的一个理解运用到我们的日常生活中，然后即使就是在失去我们生命的这样的一个代价下，我们也要确保我们拥有这两个特质，好好的守护我们的这样的心。所以哪怕到来世，我们的学习还是能够继续的。那从整个菩萨戒的角度来说，不是说要因为我们非常的在意自己，而是说当我们好好守护自己的心的话，首先我们不会伤害到别人，再者我们可以更进一步的去保护别人，这个就是整个菩萨修持的一个核心。
I'm reminded by some an example of like altruism and altruism informed by intelligence, I would say. I'm not saying it's bodhicitta, yeah, because bodhicitta, you know, needs the element of like liberating beings from suffering, having them achieve the state of Buddha. But nonetheless, I'm reminded of this true example, a true case of like altruism. I don't know if you remember this. When the nuclear plant in Japan, right, during a tsunami was compromised, Fukushima nuclear plant. So in that area, the older people, people in the 70s and 80s, they volunteered to go into the nuclear plant to turn off the things, to fix the things. Because they say, you know, like, we have lived to 70, 80, it's okay. Let's not expose the young ones. Let us go in. Even if we, they know, you know, we were going to be harmed by the radiation, but it's okay now, you know. So the bodhisattva spirit has to be like that also. Not, I'll wait and see. you others, you go first. I think it's dangerous. You go first. I'm going to wait and see. The bodhisattva spirit is like, there is potential danger there. But let me go. Let me go. And you might die. But Shantideva says, because of your motivation, even if you die. Even if, in fact, yes, is real. But because of your motivation, you're motivated by, you know, let me walk in front. Then that motivation puts you closer to achieving the state of Buddha.
李博士分享就是说，他记得这样的一个实际的利他的例子，就是在日本，然后就那个核能泄漏的这样的一个状况，那个时候就是有一些年长者，就七八十岁的年长者。然后他们就主动提出他们要进到这个核能的这个电厂里面，然后去就是关闭这个核能的电源，因为他说，哦，我们已经活到就七老八十了，然后是 已经够了，不要让那些年轻的小伙子就去受到伤害。然后，当然他们做出这样的一个动作的话，他们非常的清楚这个是有害的，他们会承受辐射。但是从整个菩萨的精神来说，其实应该就像这个样子，不是说哦，我等一等，观察观察，然后你先去，并不是那么一回事，而是菩萨的一个精神，就是说，哪怕我知道前方有危险，有可能的危险，我可能甚至会失去性命，但是因为我的动机，我想要去利益他人的动机，哪怕我死了，然后我也希望我可以就是站在前方去帮助他人，那这样的纯净的动机会让我们更接近成就菩萨道，佛果位更近一点。
We're not saying, to be a bodhisattva, you are reckless. We're not saying that. But we are saying that if you genuinely is going to practice the bodhisattva path, where you perceive danger and there is no choice, someone has to go check out, dangerous or not, you say, let me go. When you perceive that there is safety, and is not sure if everyone can get to this safety, you say to everyone, you all go first. So the king-like model of bodhisattva is to be applied when the conditions seem unclear. I don't know, that in front there could be really dangerous. That's when you have to practice what's known as the king-like bodhisattva model and say, I'm going to go first. Are we willing to say that or not? Then when, in a situation where it's like, I don't know if all of us can escape this burning house, or not. That is when we need to have the shepherd-like bodhisattva model, and say, all those of you here, you are under my care. You go first, you go first. Let me be last. It cannot be the other way around. When there is danger, we say, I don't know. You test it out. I'll see later. Then all the talk we have with our mouth, with all our theories, with all our categories, with all our commentaries about altruism, bodhicitta, all that, it's just all nonsense.
但是这边不是说我们就是要非常的鲁莽，就作为一个菩萨，我们就要表现得非常的鲁莽，不是，而是说，如果我们单纯真的想要去修持菩萨道的话，那当发生，我当我们看到就前方可能有危险的时候，我会说，我先去检测，我先去确保它是没有危险的。然后，如果当我们看到前方是安全的，然后我会说，你们先去。你们先去就找到安全，所以就当我们发现前方就是充满危机或者是不确定的时候，我们要修持的是就是那个王像王般的这样的一个菩提心，也就是说，当危险的时候我冲到前方，然后当然如果我们都同处在一个就是火灾当中。那我们要修持的菩提心就很像牧羊人的那样的一个菩提心，就是说，你们先去，你们先走，你们先得到安全，我殿后，而不是反方向的，就是说啊，你先去看看，然后我在这边等你。如果我们是这样的一种心态的话，那我们所说的一切关于菩提心的这样的一种理论，其实都是荒谬的。
Bodhisattva's courage doesn't come from lack of fear. Bodhisattva's courage comes from seeing clearly. Seeing clearly, not like seeing clearly about like all the outcomes of what we do or we don't do. Seeing clearly the fundamental issue. Then even a lot of things that we cannot see clearly and there is uncertainty, we are not sure. We are willing to do it. Why? Motivated by, for the benefit of others.
菩萨的这个勇气并不是说没有恐惧，而是来自于我们清楚的看见，清楚的看见就是它根本的这个元素。然后哪怕我们不是非常的清，就是看不太清楚，但是我们愿意去做，因为我们为了一切众生的利益而愿意去承担。
So now let's take a brief break, and then we will continue. Yeah.
好，我们现在先休息一会儿。
Om Vageshware Mum Mum Vageshware Mum Om Vageshware Mum Mum Vageshware Mum Om Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om 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 Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om 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 Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om 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 Vageshware Mum Om Vageshware Mum 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 Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om 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 Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om Vageshware Mum Vageshware Mum Om Va
So let's see if there are any questions, whether regarding, you know, the kind of suggestion about how to do retreat, or the Shantideva verses that we've looked at so far.
Okay, let's see if anyone has any questions you want to ask.
If not, moving on to the next section. This next section, these verses from 24 to 28, Shantideva here is talking about, he's pointing out the faults, the disadvantages that we will run into if we don't cultivate this introspection, if we don't cultivate the quality of mind, the skill that this chapter is advocating.
然后接下来的几句就是吉天菩萨会提出，如果当我们不去培养这个正念正知的话，会有怎么样的过患？
So let's read these verses. Those disabled by ill health are helpless, powerless to act. The mind, when likewise cramped by ignorance, is impotent and cannot do its work. For those who have no introspection, though they hear the teachings, ponder them, or meditate, like water seeping from a leaking jar, their learning will not settle in their memories. Many are endowed with joyful diligence. They are learned also and imbued with faith. But through the fault of lacking introspection, they will not escape the stain of sin and downfall. Lack of introspection is a thief. It slinks behind when mindfulness abates, and all the merit we have gathered in it steals, and down we go to lower realms. The foulmans are a band of robbers, looking for their chance to injure us. They steal our virtue when their moment comes, and batter out the lives of happy destinies. Comparing like a wounded injury, physical injury, with the mind. Verse 24 continues in that analogy. So if we are physically unwell, then it's difficult to do anything. We cannot help ourselves, we cannot help others. Likewise with the mind, when the mind is under the power of ignorance and confusion, then it cannot do anything that either benefits ourselves or benefit others. Here also, it makes me think of like how, this body that we have, right? When you are a child, when you were first born, yes, there is a number of years where you are building up your strength. So in that way, you could say, your body is like growing and improving, right? I think most of us, if we're listening to this now, we have passed that stage, we're past that stage, maybe with one or two exceptions, but generally we're past that stage. And once you pass that stage, hey, it has only one direction, where the body is going, which is falling apart, falling apart, falling apart, falling apart. The body cannot get any better, really. So that's the bad news. But the good news is the mind can always get better and better and better and better and better. And then in the more kind of detailed teachings, it says, and it can get better. And even like the last moment, at the moment of death, there is a great chance for it to get super better. But that moment of super better, they say when the child luminosity meets the mother luminosity in these Bardo teachings. So that's like a supreme opportunity for the mind to get really good. But that opportunity can only be effectively used if we start cultivating the mind now. So bad news, this body can never get better. But the mind can always get better.
这第24记，然后就是几天菩萨就重复刚刚所提到的，就是当我们有那个外表上的伤，然后如果我们自己身体都不是那么的理想的话，我们就没有办法去帮助自己帮助别人。那同样的，当我们的心就是在整个烦恼的束缚下，我们也没有办法帮助自己帮助别人。那特别是像我们这个身体，我们现在有的这个身体，可能从我们出生到现在，我们可能有一段时间就不断的在成长，然后不断的在改善培养我们的能力，但是在座的大家可能大部分都已经超过了那个阶段，而我们现在的身体其实只是往某一个方向去，也就是不断的往败坏的方向走。 所以它是不会变得更好的，这个是坏消息。但是好消息是说，我们的心却可以一直变得更好，就在更细腻的教法里头是说，当在我们死亡的那一刻，如果我们可以好好的培养这一颗心的话，它可以变得非常非常的好，就是我们的心的清明，就是那个孩子清，就小孩清明的那个状态，当遇到母亲清明的那个状态的时候，这个是就是能够成就一个非常非常好的一个心 的状态，这个是在Bardo Teaching 里面的。所以要能够做到这一点，我们必须要从现在开始培养。
25 and 26, Shantideva is contrasting, kind of like, first he will list out things that are normally said to be good, that we should cultivate this, we should have this. But he says, even if we have all these good things, the skillful things that we should develop as part of our process of waking up, even if we have these wonderful things, if we don't have this introspection, if we don't have this kind of carefulness, then these other good things also becomes powerless.
那在第25到26节，其实就是吉天菩萨就罗列了我们所说的可能是功德或者是比较善巧的一些特质，在我们整个修行的觉醒的这个过程中，但是哪怕我们累积了很多这样的功德，如果我们没有正念正知的话，那这一切它都会变得没有任何的用处。
So what are these good things? So verse 25 is talking about the three modes of acquiring wisdom. So acquiring wisdom, acquiring understanding through listening or learning, acquiring wisdom through reflecting, pondering, contemplating, and acquiring wisdom through applying the information we have and testing it out to see true or not, often called meditate. So he says, you know, even if you think you are doing this very well, but if you don't have introspection or attentiveness or mental scrutiny, if you are not able to be reflective, to mentally scrutinize, to watch what is going on, to watch what is happening, then even these three wisdoms will not really go anywhere.
然后这一些功德是什么？其实就是透过我们就是培养智慧的三种方法，也就是听闻，怎么去听闻佛法，听闻了之后我们再进一步的去分析思维，然后再接下来就是怎么把这样的一些讯息，我们透过听闻，透过思维分析之后的这样的一个讯息把它实践出来，这个是修习的部分。所以哪怕是透过三个层面三个方式累积的这个知识，虽然我们都做得非常的理想，但是如果没有正知的话，其实这样的三种会他也没有办法带领我们。
So the example he says, then we will be like a leaking jar. So a leaking jar, you know, no matter how much liquid you pour into this, it will leak out. So if we don't have this carefulness, this introspection, this mental carefulness, then whatever superficially we think we understand, it will all flow out.
然后 就是这边提出了一个譬喻，就是说我们就很像那个就有漏洞的这个瓶子，然后如果我们没有这个正知的话，其实我们就像这样的有漏洞的瓶子，我们所学到的任何一切或者是累积的智慧其实都会流出。
It's like having a security system, you know, for your house, you know, that is so secure, right? Every time you come in, you have to press this, press that, press this, press that. When you're inside, you have to press this, press that, press this, press that. When you leave, you have to press this, press that. You have to turn this on, you have to turn this. And then when the robbers come, it cannot do anything.
就很像我们家里的这个防盗系统，可能我们就是要出门之前我们要按这个按那一个，或者是把这个打开那个打开，但是当盗贼来到的时候，其实它根本没有任何的用处。
So 26, some other good things, he says, so he says many areseem to have, you know, joyful diligence. They seem very diligent, motivated by joy in practicing Dharma. And they also learn many things. And they seem to have faith, you know. But they lack this carefulness. They're careless when it matters the most.Which is using this carefulness to guard the mind against the kleshas, then even if you have faith, devotion, inspiration, joy, all of that, when the conditions for negative karma gather around, you will immediately get caught. Then all the seeming joy and faith and diligence that you have also becomes useless.
第26句是说，我们就其他好的一些特质，就譬如说我们可能拥有信心，然后我们也多闻，我们也非常的精进，但是如果我们缺少的是正知的话，然后他我们就没有办法守护防护我们免于受到烦恼的侵扰，然后哪怕我们拥有这样的一些特质，我们的喜悦，我们的信心，然后当这个恶业成熟的时候，我们当下就被困着，所以这一切好的特质它都变得没有办法发挥功能。
So verse 27, Shantideva says, he says, so carelessness, so that's the opposite, right, of introspection, carelessness, with regards to the mind, the heart. Carelessness will be like a thief when...we forget the teachings, which is what mindfulness is. The next line, at least in the translation I have, it says that when you are careless, the opposite of this introspection, then this carelessness is like a thief. This thief will take advantage of you when you forget the teachings, when mindfulness abates, when mindfulness kind of falls away,then carelessness comes in, then all the merit, even the good that you have accumulated, the strength that you have built up, can be destroyed.
第二十七句就是说，当我们就是非常的不谨慎，就我们的心缺乏这样的一个正知的话，那它就像这个盗贼一样，就所有的我们所累积的功德都会瞬间的被摧毁。当我们不记得教法，我们这样的一个所累积的一切功德都会被摧毁。
28, you know, these kleshas, they are like a band of robbers. So they are looking around, you know, robbers, you know, they good robbers, they go around looking at homes, looking at places, looking at banks, you know, pretending to be customers, pretending to be neighbors. They walk around and they look, they're watching and they wait for, and they will watch our pattern of behavior. Then they know when we are not on guard, when we are not at home, when we are careless, then they will come and rob us of our merit, of our virtue, of the development that we have been building up. But if we have both mindfulness and introspection, then we have guards, and guards with the proper weapons, so to say, to protect our mind from harm.
这些烦恼其实他们就像盗贼一样，他们常常就是待在旁边伺机而动，然后不断的观察我们自己的就是行为上的一些模式。当我们变得就没缺乏正念、缺乏正知的时候，我们并没有好好的守护自己的心的时候，他们就轻易进来侵蚀，然后就把我们的功德就一举去清除掉，然后抢夺掉。所以如果当我们有正念正知的话，我们就能够像拥有善巧的这个武器来保护我们自己免于受到伤害。
So how do we use this weapon? How do we use this protective gear to protect the mind? So in other words, how do we apply the kind of mindfulness that we're talking about here? So 29 to 33, Shantideva we'll talk about this.
然后在第29到33季，基本上就是几天菩萨会跟我们分享，那我们应该怎么去守护这一颗心，我们怎么去用这一个工具呢？然后就在第29到33季会阐述。
So let's read that section. Therefore, from the gateway of my mind, my mindfulness shall not have leave to stray. And if it wanders, it shall be recalled by thoughts of anguish in the lower worlds. Through fear and by the counsels of their abbots, and staying ever in their teacher's company, in those endowed with fortune and devotion, mindfulness is cultivated easily. The Buddhas and the Bodhisattvas both possess unclouded vision, seeing everything. All eyes open to their gaze, and likewise I am always in their presence. One who has such thoughts as these will gain devotion and a sense of fear and shame. For such a one, the memory of Buddha rises frequently before the mind. When mindfulness is stationed as a sentinel, a guard upon the threshold of the mind, introspection will be likewise there, returning when forgotten or dispersed. So here, Shantideva says, so the first thing is, he says, remembering the teachings that the Buddha gave, remembering most in this context, right, the prescriptions and proscriptions, the things that the Buddha said, you know, the following actions, you avoid, you minimize, the following actions of body, speech and mind, you increase. So he says that we should always recall or remember them. And if we find that that is declining, then he says you can introduce some fear factor, we can say, into your practice. So in his context, you know, telling people to remember, hey, don't forget the hell realms. These kleshas can bring you to the hell realms. Can be very effective. Now, frankly, in the times that you and I live in, I don't know how convincing these hell realms are to you. Maybe you find them just not very convincing. Then I will suggest you don't even need to believe so literally, next life some hell realms, but just consider how the hell, the mess that you will create right now, right here, if you forget what the Buddha taught about where happiness comes from, where suffering comes from. So this verse can also work in this way and say, have you considered the mess that we will get into if we forget, if we lack remembrance, if we don't recall these teachings that the Buddha has given us?
而首先就是记得佛陀的教法，也就是说在这一个文脉里面就是提到佛陀教我们什么应该做，什么不应该做，什么应该避免，什么应该增广，然后应该要时时的去提起，时时的去忆起。然后当我们发现自己就是有退失的时候，我们可以把就是这一个恐惧的这样的一个因素注入到我们的修持里面，也就是去忆起，如果我们不这么做，缺乏正念正知的话，我们可能下辈子就会堕入到这个地狱当中。然后就是他是可以在这个时代，可能我不太确定，就李博士说不太确定到底对你来说这个地狱是有多么的具有说服力。但是他可以建议的是说，就只是看看，如果当我们缺乏正念正知的时候，忘记了佛陀的教导的时候，那我们到底会造作多少的苦，会造作多少的让我们困扰的事情。所以只要当我们想到我们缺乏正念正知，忘掉佛陀的教导，然后让我们陷入这样的一个困境的话，我们就会更加的警惕。
So verse 30 says, for those endowed, I'll start with the last two lines of verse 30, at least in the translation I haveIt says, in those endowed with fortune and devotion, then remembering these teachings can be cultivated easily. So here is talking about in relation to having guides and teachers. If we have fortune, meaning if we have created the kind of positive karma,to meet these guides and these teachers that we also have devotion and confidence in, then, Shantideva says, then it's a lot easier to not forget the teachings.
然后在第三十记，就是说，那对于那些具有善性者，或者是恒时就能够恒时的生正念，那为什么这边提到的其实是说我们拥有那样的一个缘分，那样的一种幸运，还有我们的信心去就是能够遇到我们的上师，然后我们也去制造了就累积了足够的这样的一个善业去遇到我们的上师，然后这一个是对于我们能够忆持教法来说是更容易的。
So here the beginning of this verse says through fear, meaning this is referring to fearing suffering. So through fearing suffering on the one hand, and through the kind guidance of teachers, and we make effort to seek their guidance,then in that way, you know, having teachers, having guides, can greatly help us not forget the teachings.
在这一边就会有提到说，这两个有从两个层面，一个就是畏堕闻法语，就是我们害怕就堕入下堕这样的一种恐惧。然后再加上我们拥有就是上师的一个指导，然后我们自己努力的去寻求他们的指导的话，那对我们本身是有非常非常大的帮助。
31, 32 is saying, And then furthermore, you can also think of how all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas are always aware of, always thinking about our welfare, always thinking about our wellness. And so we are always in their presence. So then now, Shantideva is using this particular psychology to say, if you are aware, you know, of how much Buddhas and Bodhisattvas care about our happiness, how much they care that we don't suffer, so they are always there. And because of understanding that they are always looking out for us, then we also should have a sense of fear and shame for disappointing them. Like, they care so much about us, and yet we do things, you know, that destroy our own chances of happiness. So it's almost like the comparison is like, you know, we don't want to let down our parents. Not saying that, you know, we're not using the example of parents that are manipulative, but rather parents that, you know, we can see, you know, that nothing makes them happier if we are well and safe and doing well in this world. And therefore, out of not wanting to disappoint them, to stress them, we are vigilant. So this is the psychology is there. So he says, for such a one, the memory of Buddha rises frequently before the mind. Then by being mindful of the Buddhas, it can also protect us from harm. And this is why, you know, teachings say repeat mantra, meditate on the Buddha. It's not so that, you know, oh, Buddhas can then solve our problems. Oh, you think of me so much, so I'll give you a discount from suffering. No, it's not. This is not how it works.
啊，就31、32记就进一步的是说，当我们想到就诸佛菩萨其实时时刻刻都想着我们自己的安乐，然后都常常出现在我们的当下，那这个是某一种特殊的一种心理的引导。然后就是如果我们觉知到，但诸佛菩萨是多么的关心我们，我们了解到他们就是时时刻刻都在关心着我们，然后我们就会升起一种惭愧心，然后不想要去让他们失望，不想要就是他们那么的关心我们的安乐，但是我们却自己亲手的去摧毁了自己的安乐。那作为一个从世俗的角度来做一个比较的话，就是说我们不让我们的父母然后就是失望，就我们就不要让他们感到难过。那我们时时的就是去意念意持然后佛陀的功德，然后我们不断的可能就透过去持咒或者是去修持佛随念之类这样的修持，其实是能够保护我们免于受到伤害，免于痛苦。
Then verse 33, when mindfulness is stationed as a sentinel, like as a guard, as a guard for the mind, then carefulness will also be there, introspection will be there.
第三十三句就是说，如果正念就作为一个守护我们心的这样的一个特质存在的话，那正知也会伴随作用。
There is a question. How can a bodhisattva be disappointed in our non-virtue actions if they are free from attachment and expectations? You are overanalyzing this. Shantideva is not being a philosopher here. Shantideva is appealing to our emotions. We have to read Shantideva as poetry.
然后黎博士的一个回应就是说，其实吉天菩萨在这边，其实他是比较是针对我们的一个情绪的一个需求来陈述的，而不是说是从一个哲学性的一个角度来谈。
Ultimately, it's talking about using our confusion to undermine confusion.
究竟来说，就是我们怎么利用我们的烦恼来对治我们的烦恼
？Using our categories to go beyond categories，
来用我们的认知的内容来超越我们的认知的内容。
Unfortunately, I feel you know in the scholastic tradition, people have.Dissected this text, cut it apart, like they're analyzing some science experiment. You know, every line they try to make it all agree, you know, according to the logic, the rules of logic. You know, so this I think when we started this course, I said, you know, this is like that scene from Dead Poets Society. You all remember that, you know.Robin Williams says the new English literature teacher to come to the school, and so you know when they're reading the anthology of poetry, there is the analysis based on you know these criteria, this criteria, this criteria. You analyze it this way, this way, this way. There are four types of this and six types of that, you know.And then he just ripped it apart and he threw it away. He said, throw all of that away. Sometimes I feel like that, you know, about some of these teachings. It's good, yes, of course, you know, to gain clarity. But if in our efforts to gain clarity, the tools to help us have clarity, you know, becomes...prison then we are now very clear but very clearly in prison yes that section the introduction to that is called understanding poetry so the question is a very good question because you know we have been trapped in this you knowWe think that, oh, this is how we study the Dharma, you know, especially the early Kagyupa masters, Milarepa, Kampopa, Pamodrupa, Jiten Sumgan, and they were all like, you know, like, yes, yes, you could do that, you could study that, but don't forget, you know, what this is about, yeah.
尼博士就是很感慨说，其实确实，可能在整个就是比较学术的这样的一个传统，就常常会把这样的一种教法，然后就是把它分析的非常非常的仔细，然后很有条理、很有逻辑。然后其实他的感觉就很像在就美国有一部片叫《Deep Poet Society》，然后里面就是这个主角他在教导这个诗歌诗集的时候，就是简介关于诗集的简介，我们应该要怎么去分析这个诗集？应该这样分析，那样分析，然后有条理的分析。然后那个主角就直接把那个教科书直接把它撕掉，然后就把它抛弃。然后确实，李博士就是说是很好，就是有系统的来分析，是能够增加我们的清晰度。但是这一个工具让我们可以增加清晰度，这样的工具，就是逐渐的会，就是如果我们不小心的话，它就会变成。我们的监狱， 然后就是牢牢的套着我们，所以我们如果被困在这样的一种状态的话，其实就是本末倒置。那在早期的这一些噶举派的上师，就譬如说密勒瑞巴尊者、冈波巴大师，或者是帕摩珠巴，或者是护主吉田颂公，其实他们都知道说啊，这些很好，但是更重要的，我们是要知道它整个运作的原理。
Then in a more practical way, I can say, you know, so like with my teachers, you know, I know they don't judge me. That part I know, they're not judgmental. But because I care about what they think, right? Yes, of course, this is, you could say, is some kind of samsaric worldly concern. I care about what they think. So when I'm around them, you know,I will take extra care to behave. So this is what Shantideva is saying. If you can feel the presence of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas around you, even though you know they don't judge you, but you yourself are ashamed, shy, to act in negative ways,So then, we become more careful.
我从一个更实际的一个状态来说，就是，黎博士的上司，他知道他们是不会批判他，但是因为黎博士非常关心他们怎么想的，当然这个是比较世俗的一种关怀。然后就是当黎博士在他的上司身边的时候，他会非常非常的小心，会非常的照顾，就是。很多的细节，就是当，就是很像文中提到的，当我们在诸佛菩萨身边的时候，我们会升起一种惭愧心，就是提醒自己不要陷入那种负面的行为状态，我们会非常非常的谨慎。
So yes, so this chapter, even though the title of this chapter is, introspection or carefulness.It really is about both that mindfulness, that remembering all the teachings of the Buddha, and careful this mental scrutiny. So these two are always together, these two sides.
虽然第五章它主要是讲正知，但是其实它的内容都是环绕在正念真知上，这两个特质是相应随行的，是不能分割的。
Not just neutral mental factors, but in fact, if Shantideva later you'll see, you know, even like what's normally considered unskillful, like he says, anger. You're so habituated to becoming angry. Here, let me teach you. How to use your anger to be angry at anger itself.
yeah. 这个并不是一种中立的一种心理状态，而是哪怕是说当我们的心出现一些不善巧的这样的一种心理状态的时候，我们也可以利用那样的一种心理状态来对峙我们的反应。
And then maybe at 8th bhumi, 9th bhumi, 10th bhumi, you know, then you have to also get rid of, you know, anger itself.
可能就是到第八、第九、第十地的菩萨，然后就是可以去去除的嗔心。
But Shantideva is not saying, you know, he's not saying,someone who doesn't have anger, you go and teach them how to be angry skillfully. He's not saying that.
然后吉田菩萨不是说，某些人他。
But what he is saying is, you know, if you already have anger, let me teach you to direct your anger differently.
然后吉田菩萨不是说某人可能他不是那么的倾向于就是愤怒。然后我们就跑去那边跟他说：“哦，我教你怎么对治你的嗔心。” 不是，而是当你自己有称心的时候，然后它是要来引导我们怎么去转移我们的称心。
Devotional aspect of our practice, feeling the presence of the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, caring about us, watching us, and so when we feel more their presence, you know, then we also put forward, right? Fake it until you make it. Yes, it's faking it, you know. You could say like, it's a little bit hypocritical, you know. In front of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, I will behave, you know. Just like sometimes people say, you know, Jesus is coming, get back. You know? Jesus is returning, get busy. Look busy. But yes, you can say, you know, it's a little bit hypocritical, but it's skillful hypocritical. So likewise, like with regards to actual teacher, actual guides, Shantideva says, you know, the section right before that, he says, so if you have that kind of admiration and respect for certain individuals, it's good to be around them more, because then your vigilance can also increase.
而这一个是相对比较的是从信心的一个角度的一种修持，然后就是当我们可以感受到或者是忆起诸佛菩萨的存在的话，那我们就会更有力量，更能够去把就是佛法就实践出来。然后当然这个是有点就可能相对的比较造作，然后可能有点虚伪，但是这样的一种虚伪是一种善巧的虚伪，我们就是去观想。然后到我们就是真的就全身心的可以感受到那样的一种关怀。然后同样的就是像前记的时候就提到，如果当上师存在的时候，那如果在这个我们尊重的对象面前，我们多去亲近他们，我们自己也会更有力的去应用上我们的正念之母之，防止我们受到伤害。
So in this section, he's showing how both, you know, fear, like healthy fear, and admiration and devotion have their place. So the first, right, the verse 29, you could say, is sort of a type of like scaring the bejesus out of you, as we say. I don't know how to translate that, sorry. We in English, we say, you know, scare the bejesus out of you, like, you know, using Jesus as in the fires of hell to scare you out of misbehaving, scare you so that you don't misbehave, to scare the bejesus out of you. So that method, Shantideva says, you know, if it's helpful, you can use that. But he actually spends more time talking about how the other way, which is be around your teachers that you admire, that you respect, and so being around them more will encourage you to be to have more vigilance. And then of course you cannot always be around teachers, then even think, you know, Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, they're always present, then also giving rise to okay, I will do better. I will not disappoint you, I will not let you down, I have made this promise, you know. So to be encouraged and inspired that way.
那在这一段，其实吉天菩萨就是善用两种不同的角度，一个是就是健康的一种恐惧，然后另外一个则是善用我们的这一种敬仰，还有我们的信心，来让他们发挥作用。然后就是说，如果是那个恐惧的话，就是说，如果这个方式太有效的话，然后吉天菩萨说，我们可以善用这样的一种方式来帮助我们培养正念正知。那其实相对于这个采用恐惧的这个部分，其实吉天菩萨花更多的时间着重在怎么利用我们的这种敬仰的心。信心，具有信心的心，来增广我们的修持，增广我们的善行。也就是说，多花时间，就是可以亲近我们的上师，然后可以让我们变得就更能够有更好的正念正知。然后，哪怕我们不在上师身边， 我们也可以观想诸佛菩萨一直都在。那我们要做得更好，就是要更加的能够守护自己的心，然后不让他们失望。
Judy, did you have something to add, or?
It seemed, I mean, it almost feels, thinking about it in this way, a bit theistic, but we need to remember that these Buddhas and Bodhisattvas are not out there, even though it can be helpful to feel like...
Well, they are out there.
Well, I thought this is all mind and, I mean...
No, Judy. Am I out there or not?
Well, I'm not talking about our teachers. I'm talking...
Well,
about...
no, it doesn't matter. Buddhas and Bodhisattvas are also out there in the way that I'm out there. You are out there. Bodhisattvas and Buddhas are also in there in that I'm in there and you are in there.
I get, that's what I'm talking about.
But they are out there too.
Okay, well, I'm... Okay.
Oh, yeah. They are out there too. They are not just symbols of what's in here. Because whether I have become awake or not, there are other beings who are awake, and they are out there.
Okay.
Yeah, that part we should never forget.
Okay.
有一位同学就问说，就是不断的想到就是诸佛菩萨的存在，好像听起来
over psychologizing Buddhist teachings, it's easy for us to veer in that direction.
好像很有神教的味道，然后难道不是说诸佛菩萨其实就是在我们的心中吗？然后李博士的回应就是说，不是，其实不只是诸佛菩萨是在我们的心中，也同时也存在在外在的。也就是说，不要，他们不是纯粹是心里面的某一个象征而已，而是说确实有觉悟的圣者存在在外部。我们往往就是可能对于佛教的一些教法会觉得太过的就是唯心主义，但是实际上确实实实在在是有觉悟的圣者存在。不要忘记这一点。
This is one of my main criticisms of certain aspects. I would not make a general statement, but certain aspects of so-called secular Buddhism. It's this thing whereby, you know, everything is symbolic, everything is mine, everything is just about myself, but myself is real. This is a big problem. Where we reduce, you know, everything. So we kind of like, to our detriment, we think, Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, that's just symbols of what's really in here. So that's not real, but this is very real. Uh-oh.
Dr. Lai. Yeah.
Hold on, let's give them a chance to translate the interpreters.
然后李博士就继续分享说，其实他就对于现在就比较就是世俗的佛教有这样的一种批评，就是说所有一切其实都是心造作的，然后都是关于我自己，关于我而已，然后所以我变得非常的真实，非常的具体，然后外在一切都是不是真实的，都不是具体，所以这个是非常的一种非常大的谬误。
Yes, go ahead,
Dr. Lai. So I also heard, you know, a Geshe who was answering a similar type of question. I think the question was if yidams really existed or not, and he said they existed, and I was like, what? They really do exist in a sense that they are enlightened beings out there. And
yes.
Answer was that, and I was like, a little bit taken aback at first, but it was like, yeah, that's true.
Yes, the idams in the Vajrayana tradition, you know, yes, they exist, you know, but they don't exist in a way of like we think of like an all-powerful God exists out there. In the Buddhist tradition, when we say Buddhism, Buddha Dharma is non-theistic. We're not talking about, you know, whether they are there or not there. You know, we're more talking about in this system, we don't operate under the system of happiness and suffering comes from somewhere else. Happiness comes from pleasing someone else. Suffering comes from disobeying somebody else. Fundamentally, when we say that we are not a theistic tradition, we're not talking so much even about are there gods out there or are there demons out there or not. We say that is a secondary issue. The main issue is what it means to be non-theistic in the Buddha Dharma context is we do not believe that happiness and suffering is about things out there. That's one point. Second point is we don't think that happiness and suffering comes from a single cause, but rather interdependently arising.
然后就是刚刚有另外一位同学就分享说，他确实听过一位格西这么说，就是说本尊确实存在外在存在。然后李博士就回应：是的，他们是存在的，只是他不是像就是那个就像神般存在。那我们说佛教并不是一个神教，然后不是说他。就是是不是有一个非常有力的一个神，这样的一种神的个体存在在外在，而是说我们采取的这个系统，其实是我们的快乐和痛苦不是因为外在的这一个主或者是这个神，而是最根本的，这个是第一点。我们的快乐和痛苦不是来自于外在，不是来自于某人。第二点就是它不是来自于单一的因，而是一切因缘聚合的存在。
So like that answer, right? Tara is real, but Tara knows that she is not real. Right now, I think I'm real, but do I know that I'm not real? That is the task. That is the project.That is the work.
啊，就很像说，杜姆是真实存在，但是杜姆知道他自己并不是真实的。那像我现在感觉我自己是真实的，但是我问题在于我知不知道我自己其实并不是一个真实的存在，实实在在的存在。这个是我们要。
And because Tara knows that she's not real.Then she's truly real.
那正因为杜姆知道他并不是真实的，所以他才是真实的。
So, in non-mythological language, non-religious language, we say Buddha qualities are real.
然后从就是没有什么神秘色彩的这样的一个表达来说，其实佛陀的特质是真的。
Whether I personally have actualized the Buddha qualities or not, many other beings have actualized Buddha qualities. So those Buddha qualities can help me.
无论我是不是已经就是去实证了这个佛的特质，但是有很多众生是实证了佛陀的真实的特质，而这一些他们是能够帮助我们。
长住三住人佛。马给巴南给给 Kepa nyampa mepa ya Kone gongdu pewar sho. This Saturday, we will have class, but next Tuesday, we won't have class because that day I'm traveling. I won't be in Asheville this weekend, but I'll be at a place where I can do the teachings. But next Tuesday, I'm actually traveling, like at the airport and all that, so I'm not able to teach next Tuesday. But this Saturday, we will have class. Then those of you who might be tuning into Open Sangha on Thursday, Thursday is also a travel day. And so there is no Open Sangha online or at the temple. But then those of you who are involved in the Dugong Dhammakirti Sangha on Wednesday night, we will meet because I don't start traveling until Thursday.
这个星期六我们的课也照常，但是下个星期二我们就不会有课，因为李博士他会他不能够。
Thank you.
Thank you. Ta 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 ta.